Tesla is clearly more than a vehicle company. While electric vehicles remain Tesla's major emphasis, Elon Musk and his excellent staff have quietly, but not so quietly, expanded into other businesses. So what other industries, initiatives, or sectors might Tesla choose to enter and make a splash in? Welcome to First Class Tech, and in this video, we'll take a look at Tesla's upcoming future plans. Number 11. Continue to grow. The best news for investors is that management stated that confidence volumes would raise, comfortably above 50% this year, ensuring Tesla's growth story remained intact despite rising competition and continuous semiconductor shortages. This appears fairly plausible considering that global EV sales are expanding at roughly the same rate, implying that the manufacturer can meet its target simply by growing in tandem with the general market. According to Musk, Tesla may announce a new production site near the end of this year in order to maintain this in the long run. Number 10. New capacity not needed. Finance head Zach Kirkhorn stated that this year's volume growth, which equates to more than 1.4 million vehicles in 2022, is not contingent on new plants opening in Texas and Germany this year. He claimed it could be accomplished only by increased output in Fremont, California, and Shanghai. This implies that the two current sites could each create over 700,000 automobiles, putting them among the largest manufacturing units in the auto industry. Unlikely? No, not always. Production in the fourth quarter proved that the pair can currently function at a combined annual run rate of 1.2 million vehicles. Number 9. Texas made. Tesla's more powerful 4680 battery cells, first shown at Battery Day in September 2020, are ready for public deployment. Drew Baglino, Senior Vice President and Project Head, said that Model Y crossovers rolling off the assembly line in Austin this quarter would include a redesigned structural battery pack outfitted with superior nickel-based cells that are also easier and cheaper to make. These has consequences for consumers. Buyers in New York may be able to obtain one version with the most advanced engineering from Texas, while those in California will not be able to obtain SUVs made in Fremont. Customers should verify the vehicle identification number provided to them by Tesla to find out where their Model Y will be manufactured. Number 8. EV powertrain supplier. Actually, Tesla has already done this by supplying electric vehicle powertrains for the Toyota RAV4 EV, Mercedes-Benz A-Class E-Cell, and B250E. These collaborations took place when Tesla was still in its early stages. Nonetheless, it establishes a precedent that the corporation is willing to supply its parts. Tesla has been working its magic on its powertrains, particularly in terms of range. So we can guess that there are companies who would love to have a Tesla power plant in their vehicles. If Tesla has the capacity to generate an excess of EV components and other automakers are interested, we may see Tesla supplying EV components once more. Number 7. Self-driving system supplier. Could Tesla's autopilot system make its way into non-Tesla vehicles? Who knows if Tesla will be the first to achieve full autonomy? They'd have to beat over fully dedicated AV startups like Waymo, Argo AI, or Light Clarity, which legacy automakers are waiting on so they can integrate these third-party technologies into their own fleet. That said, if Tesla can give a cutting-edge autonomous driving configuration, is it a viable option for them to license out autopilot? It's clearly more involved than just providing physical parts, given that an autonomous driving system would also require software. With other automakers, this type of cooperation may get tricky. Furthermore, Tesla's FSD is one of their secret formulas, so it's unlikely they'd share it with anyone. Elon Musk, on the other hand, has stated that he is open to the idea. By the way, if you're watching us for the first time, make sure to hit the subscribe button and turn on notifications so you can enjoy our future videos while getting updated. Getting back to the topic, we have at number 6, Tesla Home. Tesla's Powerwall and solar solutions have given them a foothold in the house development market. With Tesla's efforts to increase their energy storage and solar products, we wouldn't be surprised if the business eventually plans to expand its home services and allow consumers to upgrade further and create a fully integrated smart house. We got a taste of how this might play out during Musk's visit to the Joe Rogan Experience. Musk discussed enhancing the experience and efficiency of household HVAC systems throughout the conversation. Musk would later use Twitter to stress his desire to improve this household setup. Number 5. Supersonic Jet. A supersonic vertical takeoff and landing electric jet would be intriguing to do at some point, I suppose, Elon Musk once said. But if I tried to do it right now, my head would explode. While this is a totally unachievable aim, it comes from the man who sent his own car into space. So I don't completely dismiss Musk's vibe here. At the very least, if Tesla or SpaceX do not manufacture electric jets, they may offer the batteries for electric jets in the coming decade. Number 4. Robotaxis coming, and this time, he is serious. Musk stated that he would be shocked if his team did not achieve full self-driving capability this year. This would allow Tesla to transform the majority of its existing vehicles into automated robotaxis with nothing more than an over-the-air update. It's probably the most profound software upgrade in history, claimed the CEO, who recently increased the price to an eye-watering $12,000 per vehicle. Granted, Musk's track record on FSD has already proven absurdly unrealistic, and many experts doubt existing Teslas can achieve that level of autonomy without significant hardware changes. However, there was some reality to this assertion. According to the business, as of the reporting date, there were 60,000 vehicles on US roads using the latest FSD beta software, up from a couple of thousand in Q3. Along with the bullish remarks from management, there was enough news to feed Tesla bears. Number 3. Questions around Cybertruck. Musk's electric pickup, which he compliments for looking like it was designed by aliens from the future, is still in the works. Despite recent photographs indicating that the vehicle is nearing serious production, Musk stated that the vehicle's economics were proving difficult. "I'm more concerned with, like, how do we make the Cybertruck inexpensive?" he told investors during the conference call. The Cybertruck contains a lot of new technology that will take some time to sort through. Even a hypothetical debut date in the first quarter of 2023 sounds ambitious. Number 2. Dojo AI. The highlight of Tesla's AI Day in August was Dojo, the company's future artificial intelligence supercomputer built as a deep neural net that will automatically train and enhance the company's FSD software. However, Musk stressed that the earliest Dojo could add value above and beyond Tesla's existing 1.8 exaflop GPU cluster would be next year. "We're not claiming that Dojo will succeed. We believe it will," said the general upbeat Tesla CEO. Fortunately, he stated that the AI's capability would not be required to achieve full self-driving this year. At most, he said it would help perfect the software so that the safety of his vehicles is closer to 99.9999% rather than simply 99.9%, a phenomenon Musk refers to as the March of Nines. And lastly, number 1. Tesla's bot. Musk stated that his team's most critical product development this year will not be one of the several vehicles he has revealed on stage but has yet to build. Instead, it is the humanoid robot Optimus, a surprising shift in priorities for many. Customers are currently waiting 3 years for the Semi, 2 years for the Roadster, and 1 year for the Cybertruck. So devoting technical resources to Optimus appears to be a distraction from the company's fundamental aim of decarbonizing transportation. Furthermore, other businesses, such as Hyundai Boston Dynamics, have been focusing all of their efforts on this industry for years. Tesla had little more than a PowerPoint presentation with a graphic that might have taken less than a day to produce on a computer when plans for Optimus were originally unveiled. Some of these initiatives, such as the company's autonomous driving attempts and automobile insurance policies, are directly related to cars. Meanwhile, other projects, such as solar and stationary battery storage, are more closely tied to Tesla's larger objective about climate change. And with that being said, it's time to end our video. Which of these plans do you think will Tesla execute successfully? Let us know in the comments. Like this video and make sure to subscribe to the channel for more amazing videos like this. We'll see you in the next video.